Hello children, in this video we are going to learn about ecological pyramids and also we will learn about the different types of ecological pyramids. So before starting the ecological pyramid, I want to tell you about the trophic level of the in an ecosystem. Okay, so here are the the trophic level is what? That is the one level from the another level of organism. Okay, so here you can see the producers are there. If you remember the food chain always starts from the producers. Okay, why? Because they take the direct sunlight and then produce the food. Okay, so they are the plants, and then it goes to the another organism, that is the herbivores. Herbivores eat that plants or the producers and then survive. Okay, so that is the second part of the food chain. Okay, now the second trophic level. Now moving towards the another level, that is the third level. So there will be the carnivores who feed on the herbivores. Okay, now after that when we move up, there will be the secondary carnivores are those, or you can say that is they form the fourth trophic level. Okay, and apart from that, those who are the apex predators are those who are not eaten by anyone else. Okay, so these are the trophic level. Now what is the ecological pyramid? Ecological pyramid is a graphic representation of the number of individuals, their biomass or amount of accumulated energy at different trophic levels in a food chain of an ecosystem. So again, that is the ecological pyramid refers to a graphical representation to show the number of organism and the biomass and the energy at each trophic level. Okay, so it is also known as the energy pyramid. So as the word says pyramid, as it is reflecting that it should be in a triangle form. Okay, so here you can see that there are three types of ecological pyramid. So one by one I am going to explain you about this. So children, here you can see that this is the pyramid of number. So basically it is dependent on the, or we are considering only the population. Okay, so if we count the population, so it is showing that it's a graphical representation of number of individuals per unit area of various tropical levels. So large number of producers tend to form the base, as you can see here they will form the base, whereas the lower number of the top predators or carnivores occupy the tip. Okay, so you can see that the pyramid has to be in a triangle form. Okay, so the base is having, you can see, the broad area, so the number is also increased. So if we count the population of the producers, that will be more or maximum in comparison to the herbivores. Similarly, when we move further, so there you will find that the number of herbivores, the population of the herbivores, will be more in comparison to the primary carnivores. So you can see that the number will keep on decreasing as we move further upward. Okay, so the shape of the pyramid of the numbers varies from the ecosystem to ecosystem. So here you can see that the producers are present in the large number per unit area, and then they will support a lesser number of herbivores, which in turn support the fewer carnivores. So here you can see that they are the supporting one. The number will keep on decreasing. So it will be, the pyramid will be in the upright. Okay, it is upright and the vertical one. So in upright pyramid of numbers, the number of the individual decreases from the lower level to the higher level, and this type of pyramid is usually found in the grassland ecosystem and also in the pond ecosystem. Okay, so this is the about the producers, then herbivores, carnivores, secondary carnivores and the top carnivores, also known as the apex carnivores. Now next is the pyramid of the biomass. Biomass means all the organic, you can say the organisms are there. Okay, so here you can see that the biomass ecosystem found in the this one land mostly have the pyramid of biomass and large base primary producers. Again, you see when we are considering about the mass, so producers, if suppose here is a quick example I want to tell you, that is 1,000 kgs. If suppose producers are of 1,000 kg, then if we'll move further herbivores, so then it will be changed into 100 kg. Okay, so as you will move further, there will be the biomass will become less. Similarly, the primary consumer carnivores is there, and then the top carnivores. Okay, so altogether we are not talking about the this one, the size matters. Okay, the size of the organism we are not talking about. We are talking about the mass of all the organism present on that particular trophic level. Okay, so the biomass of autotrophs or the producers are the maximum one, whereas that is the primary consumers is less than the producers. So similarly, the other consumers such as secondary or the tertiary consumers are comparatively less than its lower level respectively. So the top of the pyramid has very less amount of biomass, as you can see here. But here is the exception also. If we talk about the pyramid of biomass, that is the aquatic ecosystem. Okay, when we talk about the aquatic ecosystem, so in a water body, the producers are tiny. Okay, here in particular area, if we talk about, so that grow and reproduce rapidly. In this condition, the pyramid of the biomass has a small base. Here it will have the small base with the producer biomass at the base providing support to the consumer. That means biomass of the larger weight. Okay, the weight here of each organism is increasing over here. When we consider the weight of particular, you can say organism altogether. Okay, but here we are considering about the numbers. The mass, biomass. Okay, so it can be here the aquatic is having inverted pyramid, whereas the normal land ecosystem, they are having the upright kind of pyramid, that means the normal pyramid. Okay, now children, the last one is the energy. So energy, here we are talking in terms of the pyramid of the energy, that how the energy is moving from one trophic level to the another trophic level. So again, you will see that it has to be in a triangle form, and the base is broader while the top is conical one. Okay, so here you can see that broader one is having lots of energy, the maximum energy, because directly they are utilizing the sunlight. But as you see that when the producers will be eaten by the herbivores, then the amount of energy which is utilized by the herbivores will be less, too much less. That is, if you talk about 100% energy of the producers, then when it moves towards the another trophic level, it will only 10% of energy will be utilized. Okay, so the flow of energy through each trophic level of a food chain over a fixed part of the natural environment, here it is represented. So an energy pyramid represents the amount of energy and the loss of energy at each, and how much it is transferred from one trophic level to another trophic level. Okay, so in terms of energy, here the below one, the producers are having the maximum energy gain, and apex predators are having the minimum energy in comparison to the producers. So here also, again, I want to show you through the example. Here the producer, suppose that is a 10,000 kilocalorie, okay, energy they are having, okay, after the producing of the food. Then when the food will be eaten, the plants will be eaten by the primary consumers like goat, deer and all. So here you can see when it is getting transferred, it will change into only that 1,000 kilocalories will be utilized. Okay, rest others will be wasted in forming the muscles and tissues and then skin and all that. Okay, Now, when these primary consumers are eaten by the secondary consumers, just like the primary consumers like goat and deer, they are eaten by the you can say the other organism, the loin and all. So what happens here? Then the secondary consumers are having the 100 kilo calorie only. They will utilize the 100 kilo calorie. And apart from that, if more that tertiary consumers are there, then it will become less. So here you can see the below one, the producers are having the maximum energy, whereas the tertiary consumers are having the minimum energy. So if we will move further, you can see that there will be the decreasing rate of energy flow. And this is also called the 10% energy law. Okay. Because whatever the energy they are having, only 10% of the energy will be transferred from one trophic level to the another trophic level. So this was all about the three kinds of ecological pyramid. That was the ecological pyramid of number, pyramid of mass, and pyramid of biomass, and pyramid of energy flow.